Guys, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we'll be painting this nice Matagi miniature from a Guild Ball game. And we will do it from the start to finish, including the base itself. So please sit back and relax and enjoy the video. We will start by priming our model in the Wraithbone spray. I choose this color because I will use a lot of contrast colors, but any lighter gray will work for it. Our first color will be Gilliman. We will use it straight from the pot. Quite very generously, but still have a control and don't allow this paint to pull a lot. For his shirt, I choose it to be green because I will use it together with the rest of my Hunter Guild Ball team. So I will use a contrast grid camo. The same thing is, I will use it straight from the pot and just apply it really carefully and tidy on the old his shirt pieces. And for the rest of model, I choose to follow the art. So I will paint his pants, knuckle bracers, and the bird on his shoulder, the hawk. I will paint everything in the Black Templar contrast paint. So straight from the pot I will use this paint, and then having a control in my brush while still applying it without allowing this color to pull too much on the parts that I don't want, I will apply it nicely. For the leather straps and all the leather things actually on the model, I will use I will base it actually with the rhinox hide. Just take a little of this paint on your wet palette and add a couple of drops of water to it so it flows really nicely, and just go around and block all the straps. And for the wooden parts of the model, I'll choose Goregranta Fur contrast paint. This is another really nice paint. You can use it straight from the pot, and I block all like the wooden parts of the bow and the arrows in his quiver, and as well I block with this color the shoulder pad and the knee pads as well. Thank you. For his tabard, we will paint it with the Blood Angels red contrast paint. But if you don't have this paint, for this small part you can use Corn Red or Mephiston Red as any darker red color, and it will do, you will have this totally same effect. For his hair, I used the Wildwood contrast paint straight from the pot, and I applied it really nicely and tightly and try not to mess up the rest of the model. And the last thing is his metal parts. So I used the lead belcher to block these metal parts of the shoulder, and as well all these little rings that he have around his armor. I base painted the little feathers on his arrows with the corn red, and as well these little straps that he have around his bow I as well painted with the corn red, and then I will later paint it in a brighter red color. This combination of the red on the bow, tabard, and the arrows will tie the model together from all the dark colors that we already painted on him. We have this little Falconer's Guild sign on his shoulder, and I will just base it with the Retributor gold. Time to wash all our darker parts that we did. So his leather straps, all the red parts we did, and all metallic parts that we did. First thing for the highlights, I will start with the red. I pick up Evil Sun Scarlets, and then I will start highlighting all the red parts. This will be applied like 80% over the previous color, but still leaving the darkest recesses with the previous color and with the shades settled in. For the final highlight, I will use a Trollslayer orange. I will apply this as an edge highlight, so only on the sharpest edges of the model, so on the feathers of the arrows and on those little stripes, just a little lines as an edge highlight. Use a Strachan Green as a highlight for our shirt. We will add a little water to this color so it flows nicely, and just try to cover let's say, most of the parts of the previous green, but leave the darkest part in your shadows. And for the final highlight, mix Ariel yellow with the striking green, like 50-50, and just do the nice line highlight on the edges, on the folds of his shirt. This is just a little highlight that will really pop out his shirt. This highlight that we'll do will be his stripes. So there is two ways to do this. So you can do like I did in this video, going with the Doomball brown and just reinforce all the browns, but still leave the previous color under it or in the shadows. Or you can just skip this step and go straight to the next color and just do the edge highlight with the scrag brown. I will use a scrag brown to edge highlight all the sharpest edges of the stripes, and as well as some spots I will just put like a little lines to simulate scratches of the letter. For his skin, I will use a Kizla Flash and I will just paint the most raised part of his skin. So just like a nose, his chin, his cheeks, and some of his muscles on the hands as well. Try to cover like 80% of the muscle, but still leave the shadows. To highlight all the wooden parts, I use the KVM Flash Tone. I apply this as a little edge highlight, so on the bow, very little of it, just to sharpen the edges. And I use it on the knee pads as well, on his shoulder pad. And as well for his arrows, just do a little lines on every single one of them. And now it's time to highlight all his black parts. We will use a Dark Reaper as our highlight. So there is two ways of applying this color. So if you want your model to be more on the bluish side, then cover like 80% of the black color with this one. And if you want it to be more black, then only do like 20 to 30% of the highlight with this color. So just go around and then use it like on all the parts. When I was doing the bird, I almost did like a dry brush on it. So I removed the great amount of the paint from my brush and just was pulling it in only one side and tried to simulate like a dry brush. Brightest highlight will be Thunderhawk Blue, and I will use it only as an edge highlight. And for his pants and the boots, it will be only on the folds or on the most raised areas, while on the bird and his left shoulder pad that have a feathers, just use it as on the top edges If you want it to be more brighter, you can cover a little more, but I use it like very little. And the same thing for the his hawk on his shoulder, I almost did a dry brush on it. Silver parts, we use the Stormfrost silver, so just highlight all the buckles and all the those rings that he have all around his armor and his right shoulder pad. At this moment as well, you can highlight his Falconer's sign, which we painted in gold, so just use this color because this is the one of the best colors to highlight the gold. Eyes, we will base the eye sockets with the white scar, and then we will just do the noon oil wash into the eye sockets, and then later when it's all dried we'll come back and just put the black drop. Only thing is this model have a really small eye sockets and really not visible eyes, so this process was really painful. And I think I did it a couple of times and I'm still not happy how it turned out at the end. For the final highlight of his hair, I did a bend blade brown. And you want to remove most of the paint from your brush and use the side of your brush to highlight his hair, because his hair have a really nice texture, so if you pull your paintbrush horizontally, you will highlight it really nicely without going inside the folds. Now the last thing that is left on the model is to paint these three feathers that he have on his knees. I wanted to paint them as feathers from some tropical bird, so I will paint them like in the three colors. I will use a Troll Slayer orange, and I will paint the upper third of the feather. Then when I'm done with that, I will go with the Ethereal Yellow. And then I will paint the middle part of the feather, and at the end I will use a green color to paint the bottom part of the feather. So I think that will create a nice transition of the colors to emulate like feathers from some tropical bird. After feathers are dried, I will use Lamenter's Yellow as a glaze, just to tie all the colors together and create a nice transitions between them. If you have this glaze, you can create your own glaze by adding a lot of water to some of your yellows, just to be like more watery than a wash consistency. After our model is done, it's time to do his base. I have this nice base from the Micro Art Studios. which I based all my Hunter's Guild on it. But because I will use Matagi in my Hunter's Guild, I wanna use him on the same base, so he match the rest of my team. I primed the base with the Wraithbone Spray, and now I will apply on this trunk the wood contrast paint. We just take his strength from the pot and apply it really generously. I will just be careful not to go all around the moss parts of the base, which I will base in the other color. But even if you do, just leave it like that, because we will use the green as our next color, and it will create a really nice effect. The green parts, I will use Dark Angels Green, another contrast paint, and just I will apply it on the all the moss parts on the base around the trunk, and as well he have like little moss parts on top of the trunk on the side, so you can do them as well. After everything is dried very well, it took for me like a good half an hour, so I will dry brush the whole base with the Bane Blade Brown. So just go multiple times after you have like a nice transition of the highlight that you like, and highlight every single part of the base really nicely. Just give it a proper dry brush. Leaves and the moss, I choose a Deathwold Forest. Just add a good amount of water to it, so you want this color to flow nicely and to be a semi-transparent. You don't want to cover too much of the colors under it. So go around the base and do the moss, a little highlight, and this vine that there is there, and all the little details that you want, but don't overdo it, because you don't want it to be really bright. The last thing to paint on this model will be to paint the rim of the base black, or paint it any color that suits you. With this done, it's time to transfer our model to the base. I always pin the models on my bases, so I will show you how I usually do it. So I just take these clippers and I just cut this little metal part under it. So I will create like two little pegs, which I will later drill the holes in the base, and I will just put these little pegs in and use the super glue to fix it in the place. So our model will stand really nicely on the base, and there is no way it will ever fall down from it if you use it during the play. Thank you. And that's it. This is how the model finally looks. So guys, thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and make a comment below if you have any suggestions or you would like to see me painting something else or doing something different kind of approach. Hope to see you back on the channel, and have a nice day. Bye bye.